Dear students, good afternoon. Today, in this video lecture, we will discuss about theories of filtration. In the previous lecture, we had a discussion on some other factors which are related with the filtration, like what is filtration, types of filtration, and what are the various factors on this filtration depends. Later on, next video lecture, we had a discussion on the various mechanisms. So today in this lecture, we have a discussion on the theories of the filtration. So as I have in here, so there are three main theories on which the filtration depends. First one is the Poiseuille's theory. Second is the Darcy's theory. And the third theory was proposed by Cozzani and Carmen, and the name is Cozzani-Carmen theory. Right. So different scientists or different persons proposed different theories related to the process of the filtration. Now, first point is, what is the base behind these theories, or how filtration is exactly based on such types of the theories? So the main base is, for example, in this diagram, as you are looking here, there is a funnel which consists of the slurry or the sample or the feed which has to be filtered. Right? At the bottom of this funnel, there is a line which represents the filter medium. So obviously, there must be a medium which is responsible for the separation of those solid contents or the unwanted materials. So that medium is required or necessary. So here in this case is a filter medium, which can be in the form of a filter paper. At the bottom there is a filtrate. So what is the general mechanism of the filtration? So when we pour the slurry in the particular funnel, then because of, due to the influence of the gravity, the filtrate comes down, and all the solid particles which are present in that slurry or the feed or the sample, they start to retain on the surface of this filter medium, right? Jaise-jaise solid particles filter medium ki surface par deposit hona shuru hote, in the form of layers, they develop or build a particular structure. That structure is called the filter bed or cake. जैसे यहाँ पर आपको दिख रहा है एक स्ट्रक्चर, एक शेडेड पोर्शन जो मैंने यहाँ ड्रॉ किया है. सो दैट शेडेड पोर्शन इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द फिल्टर केक और फिल्टर बेड. सो व्हाट इज फिल्टर केक और फिल्टर बेड? तो फिल्टर केक और फिल्टर बेड इज बेसिकली द डिपोजिशन ऑफ द सॉलिड पार्टिकल्स, राइट? सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दोस सॉलिड पार्टिकल्स व्हिच आर डिपॉजिटेड ऑन द सरफेस, राइट, three theories are proposed. At the bottom side, this portion is magnified, and you are looking here. So this portion represents the filter bed, which is also called as the filter cake. Right? This filter cake or bed ko agar hum aur closely observe kare, to kuch isme straight lines aapko dikh rahi hain, vertical straight lines. So these vertical straight lines, they represent the capillaries. So what does that mean? Deposition of the solid particles in order to build a cake or bed, it consists of the number of capillaries. Means ki particles stress se deposit honge, ki jo feed mein liquid present hai, wo un channels ke through, capillaries ke through, bottom se pass ho. Right? So in this diagram you are looking here, so these vertical lines, they represent here the capillary. In the close view, the single capillary I have drawn here, and R represents the radius of the particular capillary. Right? So depending on certain factors, what are those? Thickness of this bed or the cake, which is represented by the L. So during the process, solid particles, they start to deposit and they start to develop the cake or the bed. Right? So depending on those conditions means what is the thickness of the cake, how much resistance it is offered. On the basis of those factors, these three theories are proposed. Now coming to the first theory, which is proposed by the Poiseuille. The name of theory is Poiseuille's theory. So according to him, the formula is V is equivalent to pi delta P R is to power 4 divided by 8 zeta L. Now what is pi? Pi is constant, everybody knows. Now delta P, what is delta P? Delta P represents here the pressure difference. Pressure difference. Pressure difference is an important parameter or the factor which is also called as the potential factor. What is potential factor? किसी भी प्रोसेस को कंप्लीट होने में या किसी भी रिएक्शन के कंप्लीट होने में दो फैक्टर्स अपना रोल प्ले करते हैं. फर्स्ट इज द पोटेंशियल फैक्टर एंड सेकंड इज द रेजिस्टेंस फैक्टर. पोटेंशियल फैक्टर इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल टू प्रोवाइड द ड्राइविंग फोर्स एंड रेजिस्टेंस फैक्टर इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल टू प्रोवाइड द रेजिस्टेंस. राइट, नाउ व्हाट इज पोटेंशियल फैक्टर और व्हाट इज रेजिस्टेंस फैक्टर? So potential factor, as I told you, provide the driving force, right? So driving force means in this mechanism is what? So driving force is the pressure difference, right? So pressure difference, if you are looking in this diagram, those liquid which is present above and the component of the liquid which is present at the bottom. So pressure which is considered at the top and the pressure which is considered at the bottom. So difference between these pressures is called the pressure difference. तो जब तक ये pressure difference बना रहेगा, तब तक आपका liquid filter होकर के bottom से pass होता रहेगा. If the pressure on both the surface becomes equal, then the flow of liquid will not take place. So there must be a difference. तो जब तक pressure difference रहेगा, तब तक process continue रहेगा, and that is called the driving force. Driving force is mandatory, or you can say it is an important parameter. So delta P represents the pressure difference. Second factor is R. So R is the radius of the calories. So as I discussed earlier, if we observe the cake or the bat closely, then we will find that the cake or bat, it consists of the number of calories, right? So according to the Poiseuille, cake consists of the number of the capillaries, the radius of which is considered as R. So that's why he introduced the factor R in his equation. So R is to power 4. So what is R? Radius of the capillaries. Next factor which is considered in the equation is zeta. Zeta is the viscosity of the liquid which is present in the cell. So viscosity is an important parameter or important factor, we can say, on which the filtration depends, right? If viscosity is very high, the rate of filtration will be low. So eta here represents the coefficient of viscosity of the liquid which is present in the slurry or the feed. The last factor, overall, jaise aap aapko dikh raha hai ki V is equivalent to all the steps of the component, equivalent to pi delta P R and 8 eta. And so what is V? So V overall, it is the volume, or simply we can say the rate of the filtration, right? So V represents here volume of the liquid flow in a unit time. So simply it is called as the rate, right? So according to the Poiseuille's theory, the equation is this. So in this equation, Poiseuille generally emphasized on one of the main factor, that is called the radius of the capillary, which is R. Right. Now coming to the second equation or second theory of the filtration, that is Darcy's. So Darcy's also proposed the another theory, and he has his own views of the concepts. So according to the Darcy's equation or Darcy's theory, V is equivalent to K into A into delta P divided by eta and L. Right. Some factors are same as included in the Poiseuille's equation, but Darcy's include another factor and he removes removes a one factor from the equation which is considered by the Poisson's. Now what is that factor? So if you focus on the equation, the new factor which is introduced is k, right? K. So k is the permeability coefficient of the k or the bed. तो प्रोसेस के दौरान जो सॉलिड डिपॉजिट हो रहे हैं और जो एक केक को डेवलप कर रहे हैं, नाउ डिपेंड्स ऑन दैट केक हाउ मच दैट केक इज परमीएबल फॉर दोज लिक्विड्स विच आर हैव द टेंडेंसी टू पास थ्रू इट, राइट? मींस केक से लिक्विड पास हो रहा है, ओके? एट दैट टाइम द केक आल्सो एक्ट्स एज द फिल्टर मीडियम, right? So rate of filtration, no doubt, it also depends on those deposited solid particles, right? So k कितना permeable है, permeable means कि वो liquid को कितना allow कर रहा है pass होने के लिए, उस पर भी filtration rate जो है आपका depend करेगा. So it is called as the permeability coefficient of the k, right? And the second factor which is introduced by him is surface area. Surface area. Now surface area is an important parameter of the factor. Instead of the radius of the capillaries which is presenting the filter cake or the bed. So if you focus on this equation, the factor which is removed by the Darcy's is the R, that is radius, right? But he introduced another factor that is called as A, that is surface area. Now what is the base behind it? So why he introduced area in the equation and he removed the radius from the equation, right? So according to him, according to the Darcy's, the radius which is formed in the cake of the bed, right, it's not constant, it is not constant. So if the base is not solid, then we cannot introduce that particular factor in the equation, right? So cake में अगर capillaries बन रही हैं, तो ये जरूरी नहीं है कि हर capillary का जो radius है, वो same होगा या फिर बराबर होगा. So because of this, he removed that factor radius, but he introduced another factor, that is surface area. Now what is surface area? Surface area represents that portion or that area through which the sample or the fluid has to pass, right? Now surface area is constant. So from the beginning of the process till its end, the surface area always remain constant. Surface area में किसी भी तरह का कोई change नहीं आएगा. तो surface area एक important factor हुआ जिसका base solid है. Base solid means from the starting of the process till its end, the surface area is constant or it remains constant instead of the radius of the capillaries. So radius can vary. The radius can vary, but surface area is constant. So that's why he put surface area instead of the radius. So he removed the radius and he introduced the surface area, that is A. Other factors are same, delta P, coefficient of viscosity, and L, which represents the thickness of the cake. Right. Now, the last theory which is proposed by the two scientists, which is a collaboration of the two scientists, first is Fozzani and the Kerr, and they proposed another theory. Now, according to them, the equation is V, it is equivalent to A upon eta S square, multiply by delta P upon K naught into L, multiply by epsilon cube divided by 1 minus epsilon square, right? So in this equation, you are looking some more additional factors. And what are those? K naught, it is a constant which is equivalent to 5. But the main factor which is introduced by them, these are for the specific surface area, that is S, and epsilon, which represents the porosity of the cake. Porosity, कहीं ना कहीं जो permeability factor Darcy's ने propose किया था, उसी factor से related है, right? So porosity always matters for the filtration. So if the cake which is developed during the process, this one, if the cake or the bed which is developed during the process is dense, if the cake is dense or more dense, then the rate of filtration will be reduced. Why? Because the liquid will take more time to pass through those particles. Right? Since the resistance is very high and the liquid will take more time to pass through it, the rate of filtration will be reduced. Right? So porosity is an important parameter. So if the porosity of the cake is less, not highly dense, then the rate of filtration comparatively will be high. So porosity of the cake or the bed plays a vital role in the rate of filtration. A specific surface area which is included in the equation, that is S, is what? In case of the Darcy's equation, there is another factor which is called as the surface area, but in case of the Kozenik-Arman equation or theory, here it is specific surface area. Now there is a difference between surface area and specific surface area. Right? In case of the Poisson's equation, in case of the Darcy's equation, surface area is directly proportional to the V. Okay? So surface area is directly proportional to the V. V means the rate. So that means if we increase the surface area, then rate of filtration will also increase. Directly proportional. But in the equation, Kozenik-Arman theory equation, the surface area is inversely proportional. In this case, surface area is inversely proportional. Now what does that mean? If surface area increased, then rate of filtration decreased. Right? So surface area, if it is directly proportional, then rate of filtration increase. But specific surface area, it is inversely proportional, then rate of filtration decreased. The question is, what is specific surface area? What is that? Surface area is clear, the total area which is exposed for the liquid to pass through it, that is surface area. But what is specific surface area? Specific surface area means the surface area which is specific. The specific means all the solid particles which are deposited on the surface of the filter media, the individual surface area of that particular particle is considered here. Right? Specific means specified. So the surface area of the individual solid particle is considered here, and if we combine all the particles, then we will get a collectively surface area. Right? And that collective surface area is overall the surface area of that particular cake or the bed. Right? So whenever the cake or bed is considered, so cake or bed is responsible for the reduce or the reduction in the rate of filtration. Why? Because cake अपने आप में एक थिकनेस को रिप्रेजेंट करता है, दैट इज एल. तो जहां भी थिकनेस कंसिडर होगी, जहां भी थिकनेस को हम कंसिडर करेंगे या वो सिस्टम के अंदर इंट्रोड्यूस होगी, तो थिकनेस ऑलवेज रिड्यूस द फिल्ट्रेशन रेट. व्हाई? बिकॉज थिकनेस इज द फैक्टर व्हिच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन केस ऑफ द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग फिल्ट्रेशन. थिकनेस इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द रेट ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन. राइट? In all the equations, if you focused, then you can see here the rate, it is inversely proportional to thickness. Here also, rate, it is inversely proportional to thickness. And here also, rate, it is inversely proportional to the thickness. So thickness overall, it is responsible for the resistance. So it provides or it offers the resistance. So whenever the resistance comes, the time will increase. So liquid will have to take the more time to pass through that filter bed. Right? So specific surface area means the surface area of all the particles which are present in the bed, which form a cake, overall a complete cake of the bed. Right? So overall, these are the three theories which are related to the filtration. So Poisson's, Darcy's and Kozenik-Arman theory. So I hope it will help for you. Thank you.